Hey, what's up everyone? My name is Bhagat Gaud and I found a free one-click texture baking add-on for Blender. This will save hours of your time. The reason I have not uploading anything recently is that YouTube demonetized my channel, saying my videos are someone else's content, where every single video is created by me in Blender. I appealed 3 times and I got rejected by a human reviewer. Anyway, let's get into the video. I know you guys very well. If I say the name of the add-on, you will click away. But I'm going to say it. It's Blender BakeLab 2. It is currently not working properly with Blender 4.0, but everything is going perfectly in 3.6. There is also a paid add-on similar to this with more features called Simple Bake, starting with the current price of $12. You can choose whatever add-on you want. Now let me show you how this works. After downloading it from GitHub, you have to install it like every other add-on by clicking on install, selecting the zip file and install add-on. I have a modified version of it. I changed a little bit of script as per my workflow. I will teach you how to do that if you want. Select it and install it. Now search bake, enable it. Now the BakeLab is installed. Select the mesh which you want to bake. In my case, I want to bake texture for every object, so select them all. Press N to view the side panel. Here you can see the BakeLab add-on. This UV unwrap button creates a new UV map for every object and bakes on the newly created map. This is to delete the UV map that we no longer needed. Bake mode. I want to bake 3 different PBR textures for different objects. So I am choosing individual objects. If you want to bake these 3 textures in one map, you can choose all to one image. Click on this for bake margin. I am leaving it default. Select the device here, GPU or CPU. Now this is the important thing. Where do you want to save your textures? The default pack will save every baked image to the Blender file itself. But I don't want that. I want to save them in a specific folder. So, click on save and choose the path where you want to save. Click accept. This create new folder will create a new folder for every single object with the object name as the folder name and save the textures in them. So this is the perfect time to change your mesh names. The final part. Click on the plus button to add a texture. What texture do you want to bake? I want to bake a diffuse map. And I want to have 2K texture. And the default values. Click OK. You can change the texture name here. The star represents, it is going to paste the object name here. So I want to add _2K. Now it will create a texture named bucket01_2K_D. D means diffuse. While I was installing the add-on, I told you I modified the script. This is the thing I modified. Whenever it creates an image, instead of *_D, it creates *_diffuse. So I will save some time. Also, it will be recognized by the Node Wrangler add-on to quickly add textures when I press Ctrl+Shift+T. Create as many maps as you want by clicking on plus. If you want to delete a map, you can press minus. If you have metallic value in the shader editor, you have to disconnect it and bake the metallic map separately because Blender generates a black color in diffuse. We don't want that. So I disconnected the metallic and just baking the diffuse, roughness and normal. Also, I wanna bake both 1K and 2K textures. So let me quickly do it. You can uncheck if you don't want the texture to be baked. I will change my samples to a smaller number with the denoise disabled and hit bake. Look at that, how fast it was going. Now it baked everything. Now go to the folder, and you will find every texture is baked perfectly in separate folders for separate objects. If you want more, let me know in the comments. I also experimenting with the Armor Painter and I will let you know about it in future videos. Subscribe if you are new to this channel and thank you so much for watching to the end. Bye.